Testing is one of the most important and misunderstood topics in the whole field of software development. If you have spent much time looking into the topic, then you will have likely been confronted with an impenetrable set of jargon terms and countless different tools for testing. There really is a lot to discuss regarding testing, but unlike the previous lesson on static methods and variables, I do not actually need to explain much theory to get you started with the basics. In this video, I will explain what testing is in a clear and simple way, why testing is important, how to write tests in Java using a very simple set of tools. Most teachers introduce the topic of testing by explaining some particular tool which you can use to test your code. This is an awful way to introduce this topic, as these tools are often complicated, but the principal idea of testing is so simple that a child could understand it. So what is the principal idea behind testing? We have some piece of code, such as a method or series of methods. In testing jargon, this is known as a unit. We decide ahead of time how that method should behave. Should it change the arguments we give it in a specific way? Should it return a specific value? Should it invoke other methods? Once we have decided how it should behave, we set up a test environment, such as a JVM. We call that method or unit, and we see if its actual behavior matches our expected behavior. In order to put the steps I just mentioned into practice, we will write what I consider to be the simplest kind of test possible for a Java program. Before proceeding, you will want to have the demo code for Part 3, Lesson 6 open. Begin by opening up simple-java-test-starter.java. Here I have a simple main method. Since I want to add multiple tests, I will use this main method as an entry point to call each test, which itself will use a method as an entry point of execution. The motivation for writing this current test is as follows. One of the ways we know if a Sudoku puzzle is complete is whether or not any row, column, or 3x3 subgrid of the Sudoku grid has repeated numbers. If each row, column, and 3x3 subgrid contains the numbers 1 to 9 without repeats, then we have a valid, complete Sudoku grid. Therefore, we know logically that we will require a method or series of methods to implement some kind of checking algorithm. Now, in order to save our progress and to help us understand what we are doing in this test, I have written a comment above which reflects the motivation of this test in simple language. This may seem like a waste of time to some, but the fact that we can describe the functionality in plain, simple language actually means that we have already begun to design the implementation. As you write more complicated tests and units, you will see that this step can be critically important. Remember, earlier I said that the way we test a method is to compare its actual behavior to some kind of expected behavior. This process can change, but based on our description, we should expect that a collection of numbers 1 through 9 without repeats and a collection which has repeats should give us distinct behavior. Let us create some data to represent this. I know I am working with arrays, but I also know from experience that the list class in Java has a handy method which can count the occurrences of a specific item in the list. Next, we want to be able to make some assertions. Since our concern here is whether or not a collection has repeats, a Boolean is clearly a safe and legible option. This may seem strange, but we are going to write our assertion statements before writing our method. We could actually just print out a message to the console telling us if our expected result matched the actual result, but Java has a handy construct called the assert statement, which is designed for this exact scenario. If the expression beside the assert statement evaluates to false, then the program will crash. Outside of a testing environment, crashes suck, but inside a testing environment, crashes are how you establish when exactly your program is working properly versus when something is broken. Note, I have written these assert statements in a very verbose and easy to understand way, but they can be simplified. The next step would be to implement the method we want to test. To save time, I have included this method as a static method within game logic, which does not need to be created in order for us to call that method. After you have implemented your method, it is time to run your tests. Again, you may have made some kind of error in the implementation and the test may fail. It just means that you need to keep modifying your implementation until all tests are passing. If all tests pass and you are confident that you have covered every expected behavior, then you have logically proved that your implementation is working properly. The first time I heard about this idea of writing tests before writing implementations of my program's functionality, it looked like a whole bunch of extra work without much benefit. What I did not understand until I spent a significant amount of time using this approach was that it was actually saving me more time than just writing the implementation and testing it by launching my programs. Now, testing your program by launching is a totally valid way to test and something you should do. However, it almost invariably takes a longer amount of time to deploy and manually test a running program than it does to deploy a programmatic test suite. The other benefit is something that I alluded to earlier. When you start to design very complicated programs by starting with a plain language description, then a series of steps in plain language, you will actually be designing things ahead of time in a way which is easier for most humans to do than designing the different parts by just trying to write the implementation directly. Again, this may not seem obvious in very simple applications, but I guarantee you when you start to write more complicated applications and units that this approach will help you out. There are more tools for testing Java code than I can count, but a very good industry standard tool is JUnit. JUnit integrates well with most IDEs and build systems, and it can give you more detailed information on failing tests than just using assertion statements. If you would like to have a look at JUnit in action, check out the test sources for the Sudoku demo application. There is a lot more to testing than what I have mentioned here, but my hope is that by keeping things simple, you will be able to understand in a general way what all of these different testing tools hope to achieve.